Hello friends, my name is Vikas.
So friends, in this video we will be discussing some of the most important current affairs of the December month. This video will be very helpful to you, so do watch the video till the end. So friends, we'll start with the session, but before that we have something important to tell you about. So friends, we have an app by the name Scariest Cloud which you can go and download in the Play Store. This application is very helpful to you, that will help you in our preparation. All the PDFs, all the current affairs, all the material, all the quiz questions are provided by us on this particular application only. So if you are in government job aspirant, you must have this Scariest Cloud application. Now, once you have downloaded the application, you will move and open it. Then you have to log in with your Gmail ID. Once you have logged in, you will be shifted to this page. Now, if you have purchased our course, then with the course, we'll be providing you daily PDF. In this daily PDF, we'll be giving you multiple questions of the daily, as well as 20 questions quiz will be provided you on the daily basis. Then if we shift to weekly, we will be providing you with the weekly information also, such as weekly quiz of 50 questions each. Then weekly PDF combining of whole week's important current affairs. Then if we are talking on monthly basis, we will be doing same on the monthly basis also, that we'll be providing you with a compiled PDF of the whole month's current affairs that are way important to you. This, if you are in English student, English language student, then you will be provided with English, and you can switch language between English as well as Hindi. Then you should also know, we help aspirants to prepare for banking exams also. Multiple quiz questions will be provided you, multiple quiz will be provided you on the daily basis, on monthly basis, on weekly basis, so that it will boost your confidence. Then we'll be providing you information related to various banking exams also. And apart from this, we have started an initiative that is very helpful, that providing you questions with topic wise, such as apps and web portals, important days, books and authors, obituary, national affairs, international affairs, important days, sports, defense, everything. Each topic will contain individual information of that particular month that will boost your preparation to a next level. This is very important. These topic wise PDFs are very important. This will help you very much in boosting your preparations. Alright friends, so you should also know, if you use our code VIKAS10, we will help you by giving extra 10% discount. So go grab this offer, this will help you a lot. This is a very useful application for an aspirant. So I urge you to go and download and check our plans. So friends, let's start with the question. The first is, the central government has appointed dash subcommittees to lower crop insurance premiums under dash Yojana. So first of all, remember how many central or how many subcommittees was appointed by central government? Two subcommittees was appointed, and this was to lower crop insurance premium under Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. All right so the correct option here emerges as option 3. Now if you are talking about these two committees, the first committee that you should remember is a 10 member committee that will be headed by KR Manjunath ji. All right he is a head or senior scientist at ISRO, and this committee will be exploring the feasibility of adoption of various technology based products. Second committee will be headed by the joint secretary, by the joint secretary of the finance ministry of finance, that is Saurabh Mishra ji. And all right and this committee will be working on to conduct cost benefit analysis of all accepted models and any profit loss sharing model. All right next, which city did Union Minister did Rajnath Singh lay the foundation stone for the Defense Technology Test Center and BrahMos Manufacturing Center of DRDO? So remember, this Defense Technology and Tech Center and your BrahMos Manufacturing Center for DRDO will be set up in, or this foundation of the stone of these two will be laid at, where it will be laid at? Lucknow, UP. If we are talking about Lucknow, UP, then you should know, in UP we all discussed that where the first ropeway service is in Varanasi.
And your airport, that is your Noida International Airport, is also in UP, that will be becoming the first carbon neutral airport. Also remember, recently this DTTC is set up of a result of MOU signed between Uttar Pradesh Express Industrial Development Authority and DRDO. This DDTC, this plus DRDO launched this, and it was launched during the Defense Expo of 2020 that was also held in Lucknow. That is the reason it is asking where this was launched. It was launched in Lucknow, UP during the Defense Expo of 2020. Name the bank that was recently, or that has recently became the first bank, Indian bank, to be offered or to offer cross-border payment via UPI along with NPCI. Alright, so you have to name the Indian bank that is offering the cross-border payment to other bank using UPI. Alright, it was done using UPI. And which bank here we are talking, or which organization or which country here we are talking about? Thailand. Alright, we are talking about Thailand's D-Money will be accepting via UPI from the Indian banks, and the bank that has offered this scheme is IndusInd Bank. If we are talking about IndusInd Bank, MD and CEO will be Sumant Kathpalia ji, and if we are talking about the headquarter, it is in Mumbai, Maharashtra. Next, which organization recently launched James Webb Space Telescope into the space using Ariana 5 rocket from French Guiana? So remember, this James Webb Space Telescope, this is the world's largest telescope that is made in history. This will be observing the, or accepting the rays from the universe, or the lights from the universe in the infrared region, or the infrared rays. It will be working on doing research on the infrared rays. It is a combination of NASA, European Space Agency and Canadian Space Agency. So all of these have together worked to develop or deploy this James Webb Space Telescope into the space using the Ariana 5 rocket. Which country launched the world's first dual mode vehicle? This is also known as DMV, that can run on both roads as well as on railway tracks. So it is saying, which country has launched this? It was launched by Japan. Important market. Japan launched this. Alright. Moving on to next. Also remember, this vehicle will be working on diesel. This is a first of a kind of technology that will be developed, that will be including the railway tracks for basic use of the these vehicles. Name the bank that was recently launched Green Fixed Deposit. So the bank that has launched Green Fixed Deposit, and these are on the support of the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals, or they are in line with the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. So which is the bank that has launched these Green Fixed Deposit? It is your IndusInd Bank. Alright, these deposits will be backed by an insurance of up to 5 lakh rupees. Next, what was the wholesale price index of November that reached a 12-year high? So the wholesale price index of November that reached a 12-year high was 14.23%. Important. And this data was released by DPIIT, that is Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade, that comes under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. And we have seen this record high since 2005, since April 2005. This is the highest wholesale price inflation, and it is a 12-year high wholesale price index, and that comes at 14.23%. Here it is, 14.23. Next. Who was appointed as the Managing Director and Chief Executive Officer of Punjab National Bank? We have done this question, so it will be a quick revision. Atul Kumar Goyal has been appointed as the Managing Director and Chief Executive Officer of Punjab National Bank, and this appointment was done by ACC, that is your Appointments Committee of the Cabinet, appointed or approved the appointment of the Atul Kumar Goyal to the post of Managing Director and Chief Executive Officer of Punjab. All right, now if we are talking about MD and CEO of UCO Bank, then remember Soma Shankara Prasad. Shankara Prasad, he has been appointed as the brand MD and CEO, that is your managing director and chief executive officer of UCO Bank. Which of the following institute has topped the third edition of Atal Ranking of Institutions on Innovation Achievement, that is your ARIIA ranking? I told you that ARIIA, this institute, this gives the ranking of the Indian institutes or Indian major institutions, all right, on annual basis. So this ARIIA, what is the ranking as per this or third edition of this ARIIA ranking? It stated that IIT Madras has topped the third edition of ARIIA rankings, followed by second was Bombay and third was Mumbai. So ARIIA, remember, it is an initiative of the Union Education Ministry to rank all the major higher education institutes of India. So first was Madras, second was Bombay, and third was your IIT Delhi. Which country became the fourth new member of the New Development Bank? So we discussed this. Egypt became the fourth country that joined the New Development or the team of the New Development Bank. And who developed this new NDB? It was developed by member of the BRICS or BRICS. And what are the BRICS? Brazil, Russia, India, China, South Africa. And this was developed in 2015. In December, RBI extended the deadline of for your know your customer updations in banks till it was updated. Earlier, this deadline was till 31st of December 2021. Now it has been updated to which date? So it has been increased to 31st of March 2022. In December, Dash became the first Indian state to launch life certificate system for pensioners. So the state that became the first Indian state is Odisha to launch the life certificate system for pensioners. All right, Odisha's chief minister, who is the chief minister of Odisha? He is Naveen Patnaik ji, launched the digital life certificate system for pensioners. And remember, during this also, or during this, he also launched e-diary. E-diary is a portal where the citizens of Odisha or any Indian citizen can go and look out for the work or the diary of the government. That means of all the work that the government is doing, it can go and look. That data can be accessed by the citizens directly using their mobile phone. So remember this e-diary also, it is related to Odisha. Next, which company launched Safeguard, a tokenization solution to become the first payment platform to tokenize cards on Visa, MasterCard and RuPay networks? So very important question, mark this. The company launched Safeguard, a tokenization solution. It became the first platform to tokenize cards on Visa, MasterCard and RuPay network. Which is it? It is your PhonePe. Highly important, mark this. Alright, first payment platform to tokenize cards on Visa, MasterCard and RuPay. First payment platform to tokenize. This is important. It is your PhonePe. Which state ministry of science and technology, or in which state the Ministry of Science and Technology will be setting up 6 nuclear reactors with a total capacity of 9,900 megawatts? Where this will be established? It will be established in Maharashtra state, Jitapur. Alright. 6 nuclear reactors will be set up with a capacity of 9,900 megawatts. And this will be done by the Ministry of Science and Technology. So the location is Jitapur, Maharashtra. Alright. There is another atomic research center, that is your Bhabha Atomic Research Center. Where is this located? This is also located in Maharashtra. Next, in December, Dash became the first Indian insurance company to sign United Nations Principles for Responsible Investment on Environmental, Social and Governance Issues. So the first insurance company to sign the United Nations Principle for Responsible Investment on Environment, Social and Governance Principle becomes your ICICI Prudential Life Insurance. Mark this. This is also highly important. Next, identify the Indian shooter who won the best female debut honor at the Paralympic Sports Award of 2021. Mark this, important. Who was she? Avni Lakhera ji. Avni Lakhera ji became the Indian shooter. So she is related to which sport? She is related to shooting. She has won the best female debut. She won the best female debut honor at the Paralympic Sports Awards of the year 2021. And she is related to which sport? She is related to shooting. Which committee presented this award? This was presented by International Paralympic Committee. Mark this also. So the committee that presented this award was your International Paralympic Committee. She is the first Indian woman to win the two Paralympic medals in single edition of the games. And first Indian by winning the first gold medal in shooting. So first gold medal in shooting in 2020. Avni Lakhera ji, she became the best female debut. And this award was presented to her by the International Paralympic Committee. Who became the first Indian or first foreigner to receive Bharat Who became the first foreigner to receive Bhutan's highest civilian award? That is Nagdak Pelgi Khorlo Award. This is the Bhutan's highest civilian award. Before that, can you tell me what is the highest civilian award for India? It is your Bharat Ratna. Bharat Ratna is the highest civilian award any individual can get in. So, coming back to this award, that is your Nagdak Pelgi Khorlo. This is the Bhutan's highest civilian award. And the first foreign, or indirectly we can say the first Indian to receive this award, was our Prime Minister of India, Narendra Modi ji. Alright, recently there was an award of USA that was given to Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji. I gave you homework this in the last video, but not everyone commented. I want you to know this award. This is highest important award, or you can say highly important award. Mark this. Alright, this award was given to Narendra Modi ji, and Narendra Modi ji was also awarded with another award of the USA. Can you tell me the award? Comment below. Alright, moving on. In December, Indian government and the German Development Bank signed a dash euro loan for Surat Metro Rail project. So our loan of $442.26 million was signed by Indian government and the Germany Development Bank. Who was appointed as the Chancellor of Austria by succeeding Alexander Schellenberg? So the person who appointed as the Chancellor of Austria is Karl Nehmer, and he is succeeding Alexander Schellenberg. Alright, next. Which of the following was inscribed on the representative list of intangible cultural heritage of humanity during 16th session of the IGC 2021? I repeat. Which of the following was inscribed on the representative list of intangible cultural heritage of humanity? I told you intangible heritage culture of humanity, IHC. Under this, these are the intangible, are the things that cannot be touched. Intangible are the things that no contact. Yeah, fir no touch. Alright, so Durga Puja. Durga Puja is a festival that is observed in West Bengal, Kolkata, and it has been inscribed in the representative list of intangible cultural heritage of humanity during the 16th session of the IGC. Now, what is IGC? Intergovernmental Committee of UNESCO 2003 Convention on Safeguarding of the Intangible Cultural Heritage has inscribed Durga Puja of Kolkata on the representative list of ICH. And this session was held in Paris, France. Where is the headquarters of UNESCO? It is also in Paris, France. Which of the following was inscribed on the representative list of, we saw this, this is your Durga Puja of Kolkata, West Bengal. Next, who won the Chile presidential elections in December 2021 to become the youngest ever president elect of Chile? The person who became the youngest ever president of Chile is, what is the name of the person? Gabriel Boric. Mark this. Alright, he won the Chile president and he became the youngest ever president elect of Chile. Name the Indian cricketer who was appointed as the brand ambassador of the Uttarakhand state in December 2021. Very important appointment. of brand ambassador, you can say. He has been appointed as the brand ambassador of Uttarakhand. Why Uttarakhand? To appoint or to create awareness about sports in the youths or among the youth of Uttarakhand. Rishabh Pant, who is an Indian cricketer, has been appointed as the brand ambassador of Uttarakhand state. All right, next. And who is the chief minister of Uttarakhand? Pushkar Singh Dhami ji appointed Rishabh Pant as their brand ambassador of the state. If we are talking about Uttarakhand, then let's look at one bioreserve, that is your Nanda Devi bioreserve. It is located in Uttarakhand. Then there is a dance of Uttarakhand, that is Barda Nati dance, Langveer Nritya, and your Ramola. They are all the dances of Uttarakhand. Next, name the Indian Navy's second indigenous stealth guided missile destroyer of the Project 15B class that went for the first sea trials in December 2021. What is the name of the Indian Navy's second indigenous stealth guided missile destroyer of Project 15B class? It is your INS Mormugua. Alright, it was launched during the Goa's Liberation Day. Now, can you tell me when is the Liberation Day of Goa observed? Day. It is on 19th of December. Apart from this, remember INS Vishakhapatnam and your INS Vela. They both were also commissioned into the Indian Navy. INS Vela is your submarine. Alright, and this is your naval ship destroyer that were also commissioned into the Indian Army. Next, who became the first Indian shuttler to win a silver medal in the men's singles at the Badminton World Federation World Championship of 2021? Kidambi Srikanth won the or became the first Indian shuttler to win silver medal in the men's singles category during the Badminton World Federation World Championship of 2021. Who won the gold medal? Law Keen Yu won the gold medal. He is from Singapore. And remember, Kidambi Srikanth won the silver medal, and the person, there are two persons who won bronze medal. One is from our loved India, that is Lakshya Sen, and your another person from Denmark, one Antonsen. They both won the bronze medal. And gold medal, Low Keen Yu of Singapore, and silver medal to Kidambi Srikanth of India. If we are talking about the Badminton World Federation, then you should know who is the president. Remember the name of the president. Paul Erik Larsen is the president, and the headquarter of the Badminton World Federation is in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. Name the state that was recently created. Three new districts. So these three districts have been created in a state recently. What is the name of the state that created these three districts? It is Nagaland. Nagaland has created these three districts recently. Name the multinational exercise that was recently organized in Pune, Maharashtra, to develop capabilities in disaster management during the aspect of BIMSTEC. Remember, this exercise was also conducted between the countries members of the BIMSTEC, and this is to develop capabilities in disaster management. What is the name of the exercise? PANEX 21 is the name of the exercise that was conducted in Pune, Maharashtra. It is to develop capabilities in disaster management. It was among the members of the BIMSTEC nations. Now, what is the BIMSTEC nation members comprised of? They are Bangladesh, India, Nepal, Bhutan, Myanmar, Sri Lanka, and Thailand. All right, next. Which organization developed India's first GIS-based automatic water supply system for citizens of Cantonment Board under E-Chhavni project? So under E-Chhavni project, which organization developed India's first GIS-based automatic water supply systems for the citizens of the Cantonment Board of board under this eChhavni project. So first of all, remember the organization, that is your Bhaskaracharya Institute for Space Application and Geoinformatics, developed this first GIS base. Now what is GIS? Geographic Information System. This GIS stands for Geographic Information System based, and this was launched by our Defense Minister Rajnath Singh. Alright, and it is based on Automatic Water Supply System for Citizens of the Cantonment Boards under this eChhavni project. Next, in December, which organization launched first AgriTech Challenge Cohort 2021 along with Niti Aayog to help smallholder farmers across Asia and Africa? So, in order to help smallholder farmers across Asia and Africa, which organization launched first AgriTech Challenge Cohort 2021 with Niti Aayog? This was launched along with Niti Aayog, which is the organization UNCDF, that is your United Nations Capital Development Fund, along with UNCDF, along with Niti Aayog. Also remember AIM, that is your Atal Innovation Mission. These three together have launched the first AgriTech Challenge Cohort for AgriTech program that aims to help smallholder farmers across Asia and Africa. This is to challenge the aftermath of the pandemic. All right, moving on. Which bank tops the digital payments for the fiscal year 2021 as per the data released by the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology? So Bank of Baroda has topped the list with the maximum digital payments for fiscal year 2021 as per the data released by the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. India recently test fired the surface to surface guided ballistic missile Prilay from Odisha that was developed by which organization? So now we are talking about Prilay was recently test fired by the in the state of Odisha. Question here asked is that what is the name of the organization that test fired this Prilay? It was test fired by DRDO. Alright, it was test fired by DRDO, and this was in Odisha also. Remember, it was test fired from the APJ Abdul Kalam Island of the coast of Odisha. This was test fired. This has a range of around 350 to 500 kilometers. Alright, and it was test fired by DRDO. Also developed, remember, this was test fired as well as developed by DRD also. As per the Global Unicorn Index of 2021, that report released by Huron Research Institute. So question can be asked that Global Unicorn 2021, this report is released by which organization? Huron Research Institute releases this index. It is first of all, you should know what is Unicorn. Unicorn is a startup that has crossed a market cap of $1 billion. So now it is asking, as per the Global Unicorn Index that is released by Huron Research Institute, the rank of India in the index is third. India stood at third position with 54 unicorns, while the state or the country that topped this index was United States of America with 487 unicorns. So in India, so the rank of India in the Global Unicorn Index of 2021 is third. Mark this. First position is of USA, second is of China, and third is of India. Alright, then remember, ad tech company, that is Byju's. Byju's is one of the most valuable unicorn in India. Highest valuable unicorn in India, Byju's, that is in ad tech. Moving on, which organization signed a France contrast? A finance contract with the government of India to provide first tranche loan of 250 million euro for Agra Metro Rail project in UP. For Agra Metro Rail project in UP, which finance or which organization has signed a contract with the government of India to provide a loan of 250 million euro? So the name of the organization is European Investment Bank. Next, which company signed an agreement with KfW Development Bank to provide 169.5 million US dollar loan for the power sector and renewable projects? So it was provided by Rural Electrification Corporation along with KfW Development Bank. Next, recently RBI extended the card on file tokenization deadline up to dash while tokenization was issued based on the directives of RBI's Payment and Settlement Act of dash. So remember, this deadline was extended up to 30th of June 2022 and this was under the RBI's Payment and Settlement Act of 2007. So the correct option here becomes option 3. Next, who released the book The Turnover Wizard, Savior of Thousands, which is an autobiography of Arup Roy Chaudhary? So the book that is The Turnover Wizard, Savior of Thousands, this is an autobiography of Arup Roy Chaudhary. Question is, who released this book? This book was released by Venkaiah Naidu. Alright, mark this. So question can be asked, what is the name of the autobiography of Arup Roy Chaudhary? Then the book will be The Turnover Wizard, Savior of Thousands. Mark this. And who is Arup Roy Chaudhary? Arup Roy Chaudhary is the former chairman and managing director of NTPC Limited, and along with NBCC. Next, as per the Lowy Institute Asia Power Index of 2021, India ranked as the dash most powerful country of the world. So remember, as per the Lowy Institute, which released Asia Power Index of 2021, India ranked as the fourth most powerful country in the world out of 26 countries, while United States of America topped the index. So the correct option becomes option 4th here, that the data was released by Lowy Institute first thing, then it released what, Asia Power Index of 2021, in which the rank of India was 4th and the topped one was USA. In the powerful countries, among 26 countries this was released. Next question is, Neelmani Phookan Jr. won the Dash Gyanpith Award. Very important question. We have done this question multiple times. So remember, Neelmani Phookan Jr. has won the 56th Gyanpith Award and Dash won the 57th. Damodar Mozo won the 57th Gyanpith Award for their outstanding contribution to literature. So Neelmani Phookan Jr. won the 56th Gyanpith Award and Damodar Mozo won the 57th Gyanpith Award for their outstanding contribution to literature. Do remember this. Next question is, who won the 2021's Women Tennis Association Player of the Year Award for the second time? So Women Tennis Association Player of the Year Award won by whom? It was won by Ashley Barty. We just saw this question above and this is the second time she has won this particular award, Ashley Barty. Women Tennis Association, it can also be written as WTA Player of the Year Award, won by Ashley Barty for the second time. Alright, mark this. This is highly important. Next, which organization launched the IXPE X-ray Space Telescope to conduct research on the black holes? This IXPE X-ray Space Telescope was launched by which organization? It is being asked here. So this was launched by NASA. Alright, NASA is an American company or space agency of USA, and it is to, or you can say this IXPE, this can be termed as Imaging X-ray Polarimeter Explorer. I repeat, Imaging X-ray Polarimeter Explorer X-ray Space Telescope. It is to conduct research on black hole and it was launched by NASA. General Bipin Rawat passed away in December. In which year did he take office as the India's first Chief of Defense? Very important question. Alright, he took the position of Chief of Defense Staff in which year? In 2019. India's most senior defense official died in an helicopter and the name of the helicopter was Mi-17V5 helicopter. Remember the name of this helicopter. This crash took place in Tamil Nadu, and in Tamil Nadu also it took place in Konnur, Tamil Nadu. Alright, he was appointed as the India's first CDS, that is Chief of Defence Staff, in the year 2019. Previously, he served as the Indian Chief of Indian Army. Alright, next. In December, Dash granted observer status to International Solar Alliance, a joint initiative of India and Dash launched in Dash. So remember, UNGA, United Nations General Assembly, granted observer status to International Solar Alliance, that is your ISA, that is a joint initiative of India and ISA is a joint initiative of India and France. Alright, and this was launched in, ISA was launched in 2015. ISA's headquarter is in Gurugram. Gurugram is located in Haryana and Haryana is located in India. Correct? So here, and also remember recently USA has also joined the ISA. And apart from this, do remember it became the 101st country to join ISA framework. So coming back to the question, which organization gave this observer status to International Solar Alliance? It was given by UNGA. So the correct option here becomes option 4th. Moving on. Oh, sorry, option 1, not 4th. Next, which country assumed the chairmanship of the Council of Regional Anti-Terrorist Structure of Shanghai Cooperation Organization for first year term? For 1 year term. It was adopted by India. Alright, India assumed the chairmanship of the RATS-SCO. What is this RATS? This is your regional anti-terrorist structure of SCO, and India has assumed the chairmanship of this RATS-SCO from October 2021 to 1 year. Next, which bank recently received the scheduled payment bank status from RBI? It was your Paytm Payments Bank that received the scheduled payment bank status from RBI. If we are talking about Paytm, then remember Paytm, parent company of Paytm is your 197 Communications. MD and CEO is Satish Kumar Gupta ji. And if we are talking about the headquarter of Paytm is in Noida, Uttar Pradesh. Karnataka Bank won Dash Digidhan Award by Dash. First of all, remember Karnataka Bank has won 2 Digidhan Award by the Ministry of Electronics and Information and Technology for attaining the highest Bheem UPI transaction consecutively for 2 years. So 2 awards by Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, won by Karnataka Bank. Next, Life Insurance Corporation of India received the approval from RBI to increase its stake to dash percent. So its stake was increased to 9.99% in IndusInd Bank. 9.99% in IndusInd Bank. And this approval was given by RBI to Life Insurance Corporation of India to acquire 9.99% stakes in IndusInd Bank. Who won the FIDE World Chess Championship 2021 for the 5th consecutive time? So the person who won the FIDE Championship for the 5th consecutive time is Magnus Carlsen. Very important, mark this. Alright, Magnus Carlsen has been, you can say, he is the number one chess player since 2011. And this FIDE World Chess Championship is related to which sport? It is related to chess. And for the 5th time, who has won this championship? Magnus Carlsen. He has been the number one chess player or world number one chess player since 2011. And Magnus Carlsen belongs from which country? He belongs from Norway. Next, in December, Dash of Uttar Pradesh was recognized as the Ramsar site in India. So Haidarpur Wetland, if you remember, Haidarpur Wetland of Uttar Pradesh was recognized as the 47th Ramsar site in India. Which is the world's first government to become 100% paperless in December 2021? Dubai is the world's first government or the first country to become paperless from December 2021. Very important, mark this. Next, India was ranked dash on International Institute for Management Development, that is 2021 World Talent Ranking, while Dash topped the list. So India was ranked 56th on the World Talent Ranking, while Switzerland topped the list. It was topped by Switzerland. Alright, mark this, highly important. And this ranking is published by IMD World Competitiveness Center. IMD World Competitiveness Center released the 2021 World Talent Ranking, in which rank of India was 56th and Switzerland topped it. Name the company that recently launched hashtag care for hockey campaign and appointed Rani Ramphal as the face of the कैंपेन. सो रिमेंबर, बजाज अलायंस जनरल इंश्योरेंस इज द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन और कंपनी दैट हैज लॉन्च्ड अ कैंपेन दैट वॉज हैशटैग केयर फॉर हॉकी. दिस इज द नेम ऑफ द कैंपेन एंड हु वॉज अपॉइंटेड एज द ब्रांड एम्बेसडर. रानी रामफल अपॉइंटेड एज द ब्रांड एम्बेसडर एज और एज द फेस ऑफ द कैंपेन बाय बजाज अलायंस जनरल इंश्योरेंस. ऑल्सो रिमेंबर रानी रामफल वॉज और रानी रामफल हैज बीन ऑनर्ड विद पद्मश्री इन 2020. डू रिमेंबर दिस. शी वॉज अवॉर्डेड विद पद्मश्री. हु वन द मिस यूनिवर्स 2021 टाइटल एट द 17th एडिशन ऑफ द मिस यूनिवर्स इन इजराइल एंड बिकम द थर्ड इंडियन मिस यूनिवर्स. सो रिमेंबर हरनाज सांधू, शी इज द इंडियन हु वन द मिस यूनिवर्स टाइटल दैट टुक प्लेस इन इजराइल. दैट वॉज द 17th एडिशन एंड शी बिकेम द थर्ड इंडियन मिस यूनिवर्स फ्रॉम इंडिया. सो हरनाज सांधू, शी इज फ्रॉम चंडीगढ़ फर्स्ट थिंग. एंड इफ स्टेट इज आस देन शी इज फ्रॉम पंजाब. शी बिकेम थर्ड, दैट मीन्स फर्स्ट टू वन द फर्स्ट इंडियन टू वन द मिस यूनिवर्स टाइटल वॉज सुष्मिता सेन. सुष्मिता सेन, सेकेंड वॉज लारा दत्ता एंड नाउ थर्ड इज योर हरनाज सांधू. शी बिकेम द थर्ड इंडियन टू विन द मिस यूनिवर्स टाइटल एंड दिस वॉज द 17th एडिशन. वेयर डिड इट टेक प्लेस? इट टुक प्लेस इन इजराइल. नेक्स्ट इज योर हु वन अबू धाबी ग्रैंड प्रिक्स 2021 टू वन हिज फर्स्ट F1 वर्ल्ड ड्राइवर चैंपियनशिप 2021. मैक्स वर्स्टैपेन हैज वन द अबू धाबी ग्रैंड प्रिक्स 2021 एंड ही दिस वॉज हिज फर्स्ट F1 वर्ल्ड ड्राइवर चैंपियनशिप ऑफ 2021. Next, and if we are talking about Max Verstappen, do remember he's from Netherlands, all right? And coming back to Lewis Hamilton, you should remember Lewis Hamilton has been honored with Knight of the Honor Award or Knighthood Award in Britain. It was given to him by Prince Charles and he completed his 100 plus victories or first F1 racer to complete his 100 plus victories. As of now, there are 103 victories with him and latest is your Abu Dhabi Grand Prix was won by Max Verstappen. He drives for, also remember, he drives for Red Bull and Lewis Hamilton drives for Mercedes. Name the individual savings life insurance plan that was introduced by Life Insurance Corporation of India in December 2021. So the name of the plan is Dhanrekha. All right, Dhanrekha is the individual saving life insurance plan introduced by Life Insurance Corporation of India in December 2021. Next, which small finance bank recently launched a women centric health insurance policy that was called Chola Sarva Shakti along with Chola Mandalam MS General Insurance? Which is the small finance bank? It is your Equitas Small Finance Bank that launched it. This bank was established in 2016. Headquarters is in Chennai, Tamil Nadu. And Vasudevan Pathangi Narasimhanji is the MD and CEO. Who was named as the Person of the Year 2021 by Time Magazine? So the Person of the Year of 2021 by Time Magazine is Elon Musk. We all know Elon Musk. So no introduction needed. Next is, where did NTPC plan to establish India's first hydrogen microgrid project? We did this. It was in Simhadri and Simhadri is located in Andhra Pradesh. It will be becoming the place where India's first hydrogen microgrid project will be set up by NTPC India. If we are talking about NTPC, remember Gurdeep Singh is the chairman and managing director. It was established in 1975 and the headquarters is in New Delhi. AIBA Extraordinary Congress of 2021 adopted a comprehensive set of governance reforms developed by independent experts and changed its acronym to DASH. AIBA changed its acronym to IBA, that is your International Boxing Federation Association. IBA is your International Boxing Association, not Federation. Alright, also remember in 2021 marked the 75th anniversary of AIBA, which now has been changed to IBA. RBI suspended the board of DASH for exercising its power conferred to the Section 40B of RBI Act 1934 and also appointed DASH as the new administrator of the company. So remember, RBI suspended the board of Reliance Capital Limited and
also appointed Nageshwar Rao Y as the new administrator of the company. Who was recently appointed as the new chief executive officer of Twitter? Parag Agarwal, who is an Indian, also appointed as the new chief executive officer of Twitter. He was earlier CTO of Twitter and now has been appointed to the post of CEO of Twitter. And who will be he replacing? He will be replacing Jack Dorsey. Next, who become the first female prime minister of Sweden? First female prime minister of Sweden, who is she? Magdalena Andersson became the first female prime minister of Sweden. Next, which bank launched India's first standalone metal debit card? That is your first private infinite in partnership with Visa to offer banking and investment experiences to our customers. So the name of the bank is IDFC First Bank, to launch the first standalone metal debit card that was known as First Private Infinite. In November, National Statistical Officer estimated India's GDP growth to grow by 8.4% in the second quarter of 2021. This data was given by NSO. Next, on 1st of December, the presidency of G20 changed to dash. So on 1st of December, the presidency of G2 changed to Indonesia. Earlier, it was with Italy. Thereby, India, which will host the G20 presidency from dash, entered the G2 Troika. India will be having the presidency of G2 summit from the year 2022 to 2023. So the here correct option becomes option 3. Next is, name the bank that launched the saving banks product Mahila Mitra Plus to provide financial planning and investment for women. So Mahila Mitra Plus, this was launched by which bank? It was launched by Federal Bank. Mark this, Mahila Mitra Plus, a saving bank product to provide financial planning and investments for women. Next, who won the Women of the Year 2021 award from the World Athletics? So Women of the Year 2021 award was won by Anju Bobby George. Next, which country is developing world's first sustainable floating city along with Oceanics and UN Habitat? So South Korea, very important, mark this, is developing the world's first sustainable floating city along with Oceanics and Habitat. So the country is South Korea. Who was appointed as the IMF, that is International Monetary Fund's first deputy managing director in December 21. So IMF's first deputy managing director is Geeta Gopinath, Indian American and the first female chief economist of the International Monetary Fund. Geeta Gopinath was also the first female chief economist of IMF. Geeta Gopinath has now been promoted to the IMF's first deputy general or first deputy managing director. Alright, I repeat. So who has become the IMF's first deputy managing director? She is Indian origin, that is Geeta Gopinath. Name the India's first indigenous server that was recently launched by the Ministry of Science or Ministry of State for Electronics and Information and Technology, Rajiv Chandrasekhar, which was developed by CDSE under the National Supercomputing Mission. So the name of the first indigenous server was, or India's first indigenous server was, Rudra. Alright, mark this, Rudra. It is important. Next, PM Modi laid the foundation for stones for 11 projects, including for the founding stone for Dash Economic Corridor. For which economic corridor? It was Dehradun Economic Corridor, which has the largest wildlife elevated corridor. So remember, this is your Delhi Dehradun economic corridor, and these 11 projects for which the foundation stone was laid by Prime Minister Narendra Modi is in Dehradun. Alright, so this including a foundation stone for Delhi Dehradun economic corridor. It is being said that now it will take around 2 to 3 hours only if anyone wants to travel from Delhi to Dehradun. So the correct option here becomes option 3, Dehradun. From Delhi to Dehradun Economic Corridor project will be set up. That is also Asia's largest wildlife elevated corridor. Which state surpassed Maharashtra to become India's top manufacturing hub as per the data released by RBI? So remember, Gujarat has surpassed Maharashtra to become India's top manufacturing hub as per the data released by RBI. So Gujarat has topped it. Next, the Badminton World Federation has named Victor Axelsen from Dash as the male player of the year. So Victor Axelsen is from which country? Victor Axelsen is from Denmark. He has been named as the male player of the year for 2021, while Taiwan's Tai Zhu Ying was awarded with the female player of the year award. And this award was given by the Badminton World Federation, that is your BWF. So coming back, Denmark's Victor Axelsen as the male player of the year and Taiwan's Tai Zhu Ying as the female player of the year. Next, in December, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change declared the Kazu Valley wetland as the 16th bird sanctuary of which state? So this Kazu Valley wetland is located in Tamil Nadu, mark this, and it has been declared as the 16th bird sanctuary of this state. When did your Wildlife Protection Act came into place? Can you tell me? Wildlife Protection Act, this came into place in 1972. Tiger Protection Act, this also came in 1973. Tiger Protection came in 1973 and Wildlife Protection Act came in 1972. Alright, mark this. And 16th bird sanctuary of Tamil Nadu is your Kazu Valley wetland.
A good news to all our viewers. Recently, we have launched an course that is IBPS PO exam course. This is a 25-day free course to crack IBPS PO mains exams. This course duration will be from 13th of December to 14th of January. This course will help you to boost your preparation. This course could be attempted any number of time with no day limit. In this course, we'll be providing you information related to your admit card details, previous year cutoffs, notification related to such exam and many other details. Apart from this, you can see here, we are covering the whole syllabus here, like data analysis on D3, then you are getting quiz of 20 questions with such questions that you can prepare that will help you, or they are the expected questions that will be coming in the exams. So these questions are very helpful. These 20 questions you will be getting on daily basis and they will help you to boost your preparation. So go fast and subscribe to this course. तो फ्रेंड्स, ये थी हमारी वीडियो। अगर आपको आज हमारी वीडियो से कुछ ना कुछ सीखने को मिला है तो जल्दी से जाइए और हमारे चैनल को सब्सक्राइब कर दें और इस वीडियो को लाइक कर दें। और फ्रेंड्स, अगर आपको हमारे कंटेंट से रिलेटेड या फिर हमारी कोई ऐप से इशू आ रहा है, कोई भी आपको प्रॉब्लम है, तो आप हमारी जीमेल आईडी जो कि है support@affairscloud.com या फिर हमारा नंबर 9677333862 पर कॉन्टैक्ट कर सकते हैं एंड हमारी टीम जल्दी से जल्दी आपके इशू को रिसॉल्व करने में आपकी सहायता करेगी। सो टेक केयर।